Google has finally announced PaLM 2 at the 2023 I/O keynote, calling it their next-generation large language model that builds on Google's legacy of breakthrough research in machine learning and responsible AI. PaLM 2 is Google's answer to OpenAI's GPT-4, an LLM better than its previous PaLM, which excels at advanced reasoning tasks including code and mathematics, classification and question answering, translation and multilingual proficiency, and of course, natural language generation. PaLM 2 is built to function as Google's ultimate stackable large language model, pending the release of its next-gen large language model, Gemini. PaLM 2 powers Google Bard and a suite of generative AI tools that was recently announced at I/O, which I covered in this video. PaLM 2 models deliver exciting foundational capabilities across a wide range of sizes called Gecko, Otter, Bison, and Unicorn. Gecko is the most lightweight version of PaLM 2, capable of working on mobile devices and fast enough for interactive mobile apps, even when offline. PaLM 2 is a significant leap above PaLM, and this is demonstrated several times across the technical report. PaLM 2 does a lot of things better than GPT-4, but it's still quite far behind. Starting with its core functionalities, PaLM 2 has very optimized variations that excel and thrive in specific use cases and industries where GPT-4 would not, such as MedPaLM, designed for the medical domain by Google DeepMind team, which I'll cover in another video, and SecPaLM, designed for improving cybersecurity with generative AI on Google Cloud. In near direct comparison with GPT-4, PaLM 2 is objectively better at maths. However, it's important to note that the way Google tests its LLMs is different from OpenAI's, with Google using a chain of thought prompting technique and self-consistency readings for its test, which essentially means PaLM 2's final responses is selected based on the most consistent answer of multiple outputs. GPT-4, however, does not use this strategy, and so for most of the non-specialized tests where PaLM 2 performs better, I objectively think it would be unfair to claim it's better than GPT-4. But what can PaLM 2 actually do better? For starters, PaLM 2 is heavily trained on multilingual text, spanning over 100 languages, which has significantly improved its ability to understand, generate, and translate nuanced text across a wide variety of said languages. In fact, PaLM 2 is worse at English interactions than GPT-4, but completely obliterates GPT-4 when it comes to non-English prompts and interactions. PaLM 2 exceeds Google Translate and PaLM at contextual and nuanced translation for certain languages, including when generating code. These capabilities of PaLM 2 carry over to Bard, which is now publicly available and responsive to Korean and Japanese prompts, whilst Google looks to push 40 additional languages before the end of 2023. I do not have access to GPT-4, and so I was unable to do a direct comparison in multilingual prompting, but instead of taking the text of the PaLM 2 technical report as proof, the YouTube channel AI Explain made a test, and here was his result.
I was able to test Bard in Korean on a question translated via Google Translate from the MMLU dataset. It got the question right in each of its drafts. In contrast, GPT-4 not only got the question wrong in Korean, when I originally tested it for my Smart GPT video, it got the question wrong in English.
Another area where PaLM 2 significantly improves over PaLM is in reasoning. That is, an LLM's ability to decompose a complex task into similar subtasks and understanding the nuances of the human language. I personally do not think PaLM 2 is objectively better than GPT-4 at reasoning, considering, again, the prompting techniques being used throughout this report. And the report even says PaLM 2 is on par and sometimes consistent with GPT-4 performance, which means it's not necessarily better. However, in mathematical reasoning, a weird twist occurs where LLMs like PaLM 2 and GPT-4 perform outstandingly at complex questions like Olympiad-level mathematics, which I talked about in my video on the Sparks of AGI paper. But when tasked with high school-level mathematics, models' understanding of their prompts drop considerably and they end up giving incorrect responses. PaLM 2 was tested alongside GPT-4 with and without chain of thought prompting and self-consistency on tasks like MAT, MATH, GSM 8K, and MGSM. The results were interesting, as PaLM 2 outperformed GPT-4 in the MGSM tasks even without self-consistency, and only outperformed GPT-4 in the MATH or MAT tasks with chain of thought prompting activated. If you're getting insight from this video, a sub to the channel would be reasonable. PaLM 2's third core upgrade is in its ability to code and translate code, as mentioned earlier. In the Sparks of AGI video, I talked about how GPT-4 could become a software engineer at Amazon because it was able to pass mock exams on lead code. Well, for PaLM 2, Google has fine-tuned a small version of PaLM 2 for coding called PaLM 2S Asterisk, trained on extended, code-heavy, multilingual data mixture, allowing Google to significantly improve PaLM 2's coding ability without sacrificing on its natural language understanding. Google evaluated the coding ability of PaLM 2S asterisk coding model with a bunch of benchmarks, including Arcade, a Jupyter notebook completion task that requires the model to complete the next cell in the notebook, given a textual description and the preceding notebook cells. PaLM 2 coding models outperform its predecessor's coding model, PaLM 540B Coder. Okay, honestly, they've got to work on these names, but it outperforms PaLM 540B Coder despite being dramatically smaller and significantly cheaper. Google announced at I/O that not only is Bard now capable of writing and translating complex code, developers can now export the codes to platforms like Replit with PaLM 2's new extensions. I know these kind of extensions are already in the works with OpenAI GPT-4 API, but we're yet to see it in full use, so I cannot even make a comparison here. Kodi, which I assume is the brand name for the enterprise version of PaLM 2S asterisk, the PaLM 2 coding model, was also announced at I/O and is only available with Google Cloud's Vertex AI platform. Honestly, GPT-4 still dominates PaLM 2 even at the same maths which PaLM 2 technical report claims it now does so well. The reality is, we cannot definitively compare both of them for reasons that feel very intentional from both companies, as the way results are presented in GPT-4 and PaLM 2 technical reports are completely different. The one thing we do know though is that PaLM 2 is considerably smaller than PaLM, which had about 540 billion parameters, meaning PaLM 2 could be anywhere from 20 to 100 billion parameters, which is still smaller than GPT-3.5. PaLM 2 is very impressive, and I think its strength lies in its four-sides infrastructure, and Gecko, the offline working model, might just be what helps Google win the popularity contest on building interactive generative AI apps on smartphones. Check out this video on all AI announcements made at Google I/O 2023, and this video explains the leaked Google internal documents titled "We Have No Moat, Neither Does OpenAI." Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.